folks, back on the Bossman Show. Time for bad takes on the Bossman Show. As promised, like I told you, I'll let you Jay tell you about her new venture, Pitch Vault Media. So, Jay, here's your opportunity to talk to the people about your new venture, Pitch Vault Media, and who was all involved, what it will be about, and what service you can provide to people looking to get into the media world through Pitch Vault.
Absolutely. The company is Pitch Vault Media. It is a digital PR management and branding company. And we also have a magazine that is being released January 2019, called Pitch Vault Magazine, and it's an upscale lifestyle magazine that features businesses, influential people, public figures, and those who are having positive impacts in their communities.
Yes, indeed. So, at what point did it trigger you to decide to move this direction from your previous ventures that you've had in the past? So, what kind of triggered you to make this move here?
Well, the first thing with Lion's Vision is that I found myself having to constantly explain what Lion's Vision does and what type of a company it is, because it didn't initially come off as a media company because the name kind of throws people off. Also, there were three or four other businesses with the exact same name but just did different things.
Gotcha. Well, folks, check her out, Pitch Vault Media. For Jay Monique. Now, Jay, as I was letting you know, I was talking to y'all about the bad take I had at the mall with the mall kiosk people at the mall. Like, as you know, I have 3 cell phones, and if you're at the kiosk and you see me with 3 cell phones, 2 iPhones and a Android, all recent in nature, why are you going to chase me down the daggum mall walkway and damn near get punched for, you know, trying to sell me some money? Like, why are they so aggressive? Like, dude, you're a mall. I know you're on commission. You need every sale, but I have 3 cell phones. You can't turn me around. You can't do it. So why even try? So that's a bad take, not knowing who the prospect for your product and services.
Yeah, absolutely. Unfortunately, they do that with everybody at the mall. Once you pass that mall kiosk, they don't care how many phones you have or who the cell phone provider is, as long as it's not with their company. So let's say you're passing by a T-Mobile kiosk and the salesman's coming after you. One of the first things they want to know is who your cell phone provider is. And once you say any other name other than T-Mobile, they're coming after you to try to switch you over to them.
You got that right. It's like, dude, get out of my face. And then another mall kiosk worker I don't like, the dream travel people. We can get you a vacation for whatever price you told me. Lady, I travel all the time. I don't need a vacation package. Yes, you do. You can get one with dream travel for $10. We can, please. What's the other catch to it? It's no catch, sir. I was like, I don't care. I'll go on vacation. I can go to Groupon. I can go to any other Living Social or any other Amazon vacays. Whatever crap is out there for cheap vacations. I want to go through a lady at the mall who I don't know, I don't like, who knows a commission. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. And $10, that sounds too good to be true. There has to be a catch, because no vacation is going to cost only $10. It costs more than that to put gas in your car.
Yeah. You got there right. Like, she was so aggressive too. Chased me down the walkway. Now, I about got hit by one of these. You know, they had these little trains that kids ride in the middle of the malls. Like,
yep.
How about you have a grown up direct the train, not try to take out my shin, you know?
Yeah.
And then those roasted peanuts that smell like ice cream, those German peanuts they have.
I love those. The roasted peanuts, especially during the holidays.
It's like ice cream to me. Like, I don't. And then, you know, Auntie Annie's pretzels. Like, who wants a pretzel? I don't like pretzels. I don't. You want a sample of pretzel? Hell no. Why? I'm like, it's why I'm going to the mall. Because once I leave, I'm so annoyed at all the bad kids I see at the mall, like, really all the bad, like, in the food court, every person who offered me a sample, I don't want your crap. And I don't know where you've been, loser. Your hands have been at toothpick.
What?
I don't know where toothpick has been. I don't care about your bourbon chicken or your sesame lo mein. I don't care about this garbage. Get away from me. So, I don't get Jay aggressive mall worker, whether it be the peanut person, the kiosk of the phones, the boomerang people. I don't get why they're so aggressive at the mall.
They trying to get their commission. That's pretty much what it is. They know you don't need it, but they want to sell it to you anyway.
You know, I asked a jackass, would you buy your own product, sir? Yeah, no, you're lying. You don't buy that. That's garbage. Screw you.
They probably don't even have their own product.
Like, screw you. And, like, okay, Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. When you have to turn to an all commission job for your welfare, you fail. Unless you're selling cars. Besides that, you fail.
Yep.
And even some car salesmen have failed. Cause
yeah, it depends on which dealership. If they're like a buy here, pay here, but if they're like a major dealership, some of those sales associates make some really good money.
Yeah, I know. And you know what I love about the car dealership? Cause I have two Kias. Okay, I have Kia cars, so. When you pull up in the Kia lot, they all attack you. I'm like, get my extra brownie. I don't need your help. I know what car I want, Jabroni. That Optima over there, screw you. Oh, I'll take you to the car, sir. How about you stay in that little fence over there and know your role and shut your mouth, Jabroni. I will tell you I'm ready to buy your car. I'll give you the price I want to pay for the car. Or else. Because you need my sale to feed your family. Okay. That's how you handle annoying car salesman guy. You tell him your price. You tell him he needs you to help pay his family's meals for the next week.
Man, that's cold out. I felt that.
Commission ass.
What?
That's how you attack him. He's like, get their price down. Oh, no, I'm good. This price is too high. No, well, let me ask him about this price. Go up there and ask his ass about this price. Well, he said he knew where I'm leaving. Nah. Because they're desperate. They're close to that sale. You get them like, nah, I'm thinking about it. Nah, I can't do it. Nah. Mm-mm. Need a little bit lower.
Yep.
That's how you work a desperate commission car salesman loser, okay? Say, I'm over. I'm fair sale, didn't change your mind. Oh, no, I'm good.
Oh my gosh, that's cruel.
And tell them, quote, my balls is hot. After you get done.
Wow.
Yes, people. UFC fight this weekend. UFC 229, my man Derek Lewis said, quote, Jay said, quote, my balls was hot.
Wow.
Jay, you ever heard of take so bad? Quote, in a post-match interview, my balls was hot.
So it's like, why would everybody want to know that?
Exactly. You won because, quote, your balls was hot. So that means you got fire ants in your balls, like your balls on fire from herpes, the itches, the flames. Like, what do you mean, quote, my balls was hot?
Right. What does that even mean?
You know what? My balls is hot. Like, that's a terrible take, first of all.
It is.
Like, really? My balls is hot. Yeah, I'm on the radio because, quote, my balls was hot. Really?
I mean, that is just so random. It's like it had nothing to do with anything.
Quote, my balls was hot. That's a terrible take if I heard one in my life. And another bad take happened right here in Georgia, people, is that a black man was arrested for babysitting two white children in Cobb County, Georgia, which is not that far from the Atlanta line. That's the next county up from Atlanta. Cobb County, Georgia. A black man was arrested for babysitting two white kids. What in the world,
hey,
Jay?
What?
Yes.
What was the reason for his arrest? I mean, because babysitting two kids of another race, I don't think it's grounds to be arrested. If somebody hired him, that's their business.
Yeah, like, he's babysitting wild blacks. We got arrested for babysitting wild black.
Yep. That is so wrong. That is so wrong.
It's terrible. Like, dude, that's your take? You caught up with this man because he babysitting some kids that was white. Okay.
Does it as a side job. He's probably earning some extra money or something, because clearly he had permission to be around those kids.
Yes, he did. He took an L for babysitting wild black.
Yep.
So, folks, me and Jay are hosting a radio show, Wild Black. Can you get arrested for that? At least yet. Until we turn into, like, North Korea or China or somewhere where we're going this orange food. But after the break, we'll come back with segment two.
All your photo, video, and voiceover needs, check out the fine folks at Blu-ray Productions. They will take good care of you. If you don't believe me, you can see for yourself. Check out their work at blueberryproductions.tv, the Facebook page, Blueberry Productions, also a Vimeo page, a YouTube page, and it's Blueberry, B-L-U-B-E-R-R-Y, prod on Twitter. Check them out today. Blueberry Productions, great people, great work, great service.
Hey there, your yard took a real beating this summer. Luckily, Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard has your back. Just feed your grass with Scott's again this fall when the air is cool and the soil is warm. It's the perfect time to give your lawn a boost. If you do, Winter Guard will give your yard the nourishment it needs to help weak, thin grass recover and support root growth, giving you a greener, more resilient lawn both now and next spring. Guaranteed. Grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard today. You'll be back to barbecuing in no time. This is a Scott's Yard.
Hey parents, we all try to be extra careful with our children in the car, but then we get an important call or text. Remember, our children are watching. Make every drive a good example. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
folks, back on the Bad Taste Tape on the Boss Man Show, Boss and Jay Monique. Jay, I turn up to you. You got three stories for us today and full of bad takes. Let us have them. Drop the knowledge on us, please.
Yes, we are full of bad takes. The first one is about some Colorado thieves who broke into a pot dispensary, but guess what they got? Oregano. So they went through all that to not even get the real thing. They did this on Wednesday after crashing a stolen minivan through the glass front entrance of Native Roots, a Colorado Springs pot shop. After the break-in with the van, several accomplices entered the store from a different vehicle and carried out what they probably assumed were containers of marijuana. The burglars loaded the loot into the getaway car and drove, leaving the van behind. And a police officer spotted the getaway car and tried to pull it over. And instead, the fleeing driver hit the police cruiser and then sped away. The cruiser sustained minor damage and the thieves escaped. And the last report is that the suspects were still on the loose. So they went through all that and they're not even gonna, they don't even have the real thing. And hit a police cruiser. So when they catch up with them, they're gonna be in a lot of trouble for like no reason.
Over some oregano. You know, Jay, I want to tell you something. I remember in high school, there was some wannabe thugs who was trying to get over people. They were selling wrapped up sage as marijuana.
Wow, that is crazy.
They were selling sage as marijuana. And made some bad dudes. The dude's family who were doing, his family is well off. His dad owned restaurants in Orlando. His dad had money. But he wanted to be a thug so bad. And little people were buying weed from him. It was really sage. I saw him in the bathroom
insane.
Pouring the sage in the bags and wrapping it up.
He ain't got no sense. And he didn't even have to do what he was doing because, just like you said, he was already well off. He didn't actually even need the money. He's just being stupid.
So I've seen people get tricked into thinking that something green is not green, is really marijuana, it's not. Throw your life away over some oregano, like for real.
Oh yeah, they sure did.
They need
and Halloween
all
is right age. Around the corner. But if you're over a certain age in Virginia and you're caught out there trick-or-treating, you could possibly go to jail.
Wow.
Yep. The Halloween revelers in Virginia are being warned of the holiday's unusual rules, including potential jail time for trick-or-treaters who are over the age of 12. The city code in Chesapeake puts strict limits on trick-or-treating, including making it a misdemeanor for anyone over the age of 12 to don costumes and go door-to-door for candy. The code lists the penalties for overage trick-or-treating as fines up to $25 to $100 and up to 6 months in jail. That is crazy! Somebody could wind up going as far as being in jail for possibly 6 months just for trick-or-treating over the age of 12.
Wow. Now, let me see what I say on this. I feel like you're probably like over the age of 8 or 9. You shouldn't be out anyway. That's my personal take. At the age of 8, maybe 9, if you're small, 10, maybe. Shouldn't be out there. Like, at one point, you become a loser. There's a double digit behind in your age, you're a loser. And what gets me is adults who trick or treat is like they're little kids.
Yeah, I think morally, it's screwy. But I don't think legally that somebody should go to jail because they're over a certain age to be trick or treating.
Yeah, like not the jail, but you know, just in life, being a loser and not being a loser. Yeah.
Yeah, I see where you're coming from. But back in my day, you used to have groups of kids and teenagers walking around the neighborhood trick or treating. Even people who were like 14, 15 years old, they'd be out there trick or treating.
Exactly. So, nah, it to me, it's crazy. And speaking of Halloween, Jay, it is a bad take to dress up Halloween work, okay? That's a terrible take. I don't want Johnny Bravo cleaning my teeth at the dentist. I don't want Spider-Man taking my money at the bank. I don't want Zorro rubbing me up at the doctor's office.
Oh my god.
I don't need my pharmacist to be Scooby Doo. Like,
okay.
I think adults just at work and losers. Like, you're going to a Halloween party outside of work, fine. But do not come to work in your little skid up crap. I want to see that garbage. You don't like this. I don't need Spider Man or Batman or Zorro or Xena the Warrior Princess or Catwoman doing whatever normal functions. Like, I don't need that from you. I don't need map co worker dressed up as freaking Donald Duck. I don't need it. It's terrible. And unfortunately, I'm not doing Halloween. So, Halloween for me is a holiday. I'm dreading it all. I'm like, look, I'm dreading it because I know it's going to be dressed up like the Lichman dressed up as. It's going to be black faces from the Caucasian people who don't like us. It's going to be folks trying to just was Colin Kaepernick to make fun of him. I just see Halloween going to be very bad. It's going to be a lot of bad things for Halloween. It's only weeks away, which is even more pathetic. So, yeah. And also, another one, Jay. Halloween will be on a Wednesday this year. Church is giving
Halloween's
out candy.
Halloween's on a Wednesday?
Yeah, church is going to give out candy for Halloween. Isn't that like an oxymoron? Because it's just the devil and demonic and the other world. Church is giving out candy on Halloween. I'm just saying.
Yeah, it's pretty weird. It's kind of hypocritical in a way because it's like on one hand, just like you said, you know, the churches will say Halloween is the devil's holiday and this and that, but yet they participate in it and give out candy.
Dropping that out, you know, so some always rub me the wrong way, but you know, I just want to throw it out there. Like, really? You sure? Okay. All right, I got you. What else you got for us, Jay, on this bad take segment part two?
Well, the last one is a driver was suspended for letting monkeys steer the bus.
Wow. Was it Pooch Hall?
Oh, it's a bus driver in India. He was suspended after a video emerged of him letting a monkey sit on the vehicle's steering wheel and help steer. The video, which went viral on social media, shows the man holding onto the wheel of the bus with one hand while the monkey perches on the wheel and steers the vehicle on the road in Bangalore. It said the driver has been suspended from his duties while officials investigate the incident, and also the monkey was a pet belonging to one of the passengers on the bus. But let me get this straight. The driver who is driving passengers, who needs to make sure the passengers get safely to their destination, allowed a passenger's pet monkey to come up front, sit in the driver's seat, and steer that bus? You got me all the way jacked up.
All the way jacked up, for real, like, for real. Letting a primate animal run a bus. Really, an animal. I don't understand that. So I don't get how Charlie and a 2-year-old drive a car. You know, that's throwing me off too. You know, Pooch Hall letting a 2-year-old drive a car, then an animal drive a bus. Like, okay, I know monkeys are perceived to be smart, but they don't have the cognitive intellect to actually drive a bus. They can pull a banana or something, or stomp prey. They can't drive a freaking commercially licensed bus. What the hell's going on, Andy?
They shouldn't be driving a bus.
Jay, what's the man's balls? How he just scratches his balls is hot? Is that his take? Man, why did this monkey drive the bus? Man, my balls are hot. What? Your quote, what was hot?
Man.
My balls is hot. Oh, that's your take. Sure, Luther, you're going to jail for this. Monkeys are not to drive cars.
No,
2-year-olds are not to drive cars or buses. But, Jay, I have seen humans put dogs hang on steering wheels and say they're driving. Once again. Now, at least a monkey has, like, hands like we do.
Yep.
But a dog don't. They got, what's that, what they call paws?
Yeah, they have paws.
Whatever that crap they have.
What?
You know, I don't like dogs. dolls. I don't know what the hell they have. Claws,
you're like
paws.
Animal spirits.
Hands or whatever they have.
No, they don't have hands. Just like that lady said, she doesn't recall deers having hands.
That take, my Lord, like, Jesus Christ. Yeah, like, I don't know why you would have a dog's hand on the steering wheel. I don't know why you have a monkey driving the bus. I don't understand people. You know how I value your life?
Exactly.
You
don't at least value other people, innocent people.
Exactly. Because having your pet monkey or pet dog or pet whatever driving a vehicle is a weapon, people. A vehicle is a weapon. It can take you out.
Yep.
It sure can. So we must be smarter. We must have better takes before I'll be asking you, sir or ma'am, what's your deal? Or to jump in the nearest river, lake that you're used to. Okay? I'm just saying. Jay, great job as always. We'll talk to you next week. And thank you for your tip on that liquor. I sure did get me some. And it snuck up on me.
I'm not surprised.
But I enjoyed the feeling. Great feelings. I loved it. So, folks, this is Jay Monique, Boss Man, Bad Takes. We are out.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, True Speech and 313 Fresh, bringing you 2 discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today, True Speech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
A gorgeous tan from Suntan City gives you an inner glow that relights the fire when you run into your first crush.
Vicky, who is that?
An old boyfriend.
Lucky you just tanned at Suntan City.
Lucky he's single. We're doing lunch tomorrow.
Won't be single for long then.
During Tour of the City, try all 5 tans, including spray tan, for just $4.99. Restrictions may apply. Click to buy now.
When you're a teen, you finally get to make some of your own decisions. Who are you going to hang out with? What do you want to be? Are you going to glance at that text while driving? Remember, a split second is all it takes for something tragic to happen. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
It's maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer. All the stars are closer.
Tell me what you gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
Maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Yeah, yeah, it's your man JC, the host with the most, baby, and it goes down each and every Saturday night right here in the city of Memphis. That's right, y'all. It goes down at Clicks Sports Bar Memphis, baby. 3705 Malco Way, Memphis, Tennessee, 38125. Come out and join us, the Three Kings, each and every Saturday night for the livest karaoke in the city. Everybody gets in free till 10 p.m., only $5 after. Great food. We got drink specials. We got all kind of games, man. We got the pool tables popping. Whatever you want, we got you, man. Come on out. Have a good time with us each and every Saturday night. That's Clicks Sports Bar, Memphis.
host, back of the Boss Man Show. I'm a Boss and Bone. We got a sports segment for you and the Boss Report with some Florida hurricane stories for the people this week here on the Boss Man Show. Bone, what is good, my good brother up there in Jersey?
Man, we're all good, man. You know, at least we're dry up here, so we're good.
Man, how's the game when you took the little homie Jake to the game? How was it to see the Broncos and seeing my friend Adam Jones get injured early in the game with a leg injury?
Yeah, it was his first ever Broncos game. And he's not happy how it ended, but, you know, it's still a good experience.
Yes, indeed. At MetLife Stadium, a.k.a. Giant Stadium, a.k.a. it's Westford, New Jersey, not New York, but it's all to the good. And speaking of those Jets who beat the Broncos, I mean, they got a win over the Broncos. They ran all over them with Quick Crowell and those guys and Powell. So you think the Jets are getting back on track? They put too much on Sam Darnold too early, or they laid the egg at Cleveland? So what do you feel on the Jets after five games here in the quarter two of the season?
I mean, they're going to be an up-and-down team. I mean, they had a great performance against Detroit in the opener. Then they laid an egg in the second half against Cleveland. They had a great job against the Broncos on Sunday. So they're going to be an up-and-down team. But they have talent, though, at least. And you're starting to see the younger players starting to mature as the season goes on. So, I mean, they're not a playoff contender, I don't think. But at least you see some light now in the tunnel.
Yes, indeed, Indy. And are you seeing more talent on this roster than you thought they would be? Robbie Anderson's playing pretty damn well, though he's not in police bracelets. I think he's playing pretty well. I saw some things I liked from the guy, and then Crowell, he's out taking dumps on the Browns, doing pretty well. There are some weapons there, but the only thing about it is, can they be consistent going forward?
As I say, again, they're an up-and-down team. They're a young roster, so you're going to expect some nights, some games where they're lights out, and then you'll also see some games where they lay eggs. And you've seen so far this year how they're going to be an up-and-down kind of roster this year. But the young guys are all going to grow together, and that's a good thing. And they're all right now on cost-friendly deals, which is also a good thing. And you got to have faith the next year, next offseason, when McCagnan will have about upwards of $80 million freed up for free agency. So there's a chance where they can get good and hurt next year.
I hear that. Now, Bones, into the G-Men, who will be coming to Atlanta for Monday Night Football in about 10 days' time to maybe sink the Falcons' ship for good to 1-6, because I don't see the Falcons winning against Tampa this weekend due to the defense being so porous. But Odell Beckham sat down with his homeboy, little Wheezy F baby, please save the baby, took some shots at his teammate, Shermer, the heart, Eli, maybe he's the problem, maybe not the problem. What's the buzz about Odell's comments up there in the tri-state area? And could this be the beginning of the end for Eli Manning if this streak keeps on going? But they are only on a game out of the win column in the division. Everybody has two wins, two losses at least. So, like, could they wreck the ship due to the NFC's being so down?
No, they're not going to wreck the ship this year. They're still the worst team in the division, I think, by far. But as you said, they're in a terrible division where the Eagles are probably still on their, all on the war tour still from last year. The Skins are up and down. Dallas is also an enigma. So although it seems like the Giants are in the hunt, they're not really in the hunt in the long term. Now, they may win Thursday, tomorrow night. They may win. I pick it to win tomorrow against Philadelphia. But overall, I just think that this season is still a lost season. And if you could find a way to maybe start losing some games and prepare for Justin Herbert, the kid from Oregon, the quarterback, because they dropped the ball in this previous draft. Now, I'm not saying Barkley wasn't a good player. He's an outstanding player, but he wasn't what they needed at that moment. So maybe they start losing some games here and get in the raffle for Herbert. But overall, I think the season is lost. I think Eli is washed. I said that for the last 2 years, and I got Twitter hate all around from Giants fans because they didn't want to see that. from their guy. But Eli is not the same guy. I think he's almost a shell of himself. I think because the O-line just damaged him so badly over the last couple of years, where now he's starting to see ghosts.
Yeah, Eli. You know how Prime say, I believe in Eli. I don't believe in him at all. I believe he's done.
No. No, you know what the thing is? I've gotten heat from the Giants fans for since Eli came into the league. When I kept saying that he is the third best QB in that draft, I have Ben and I Rivers ahead of him all time and the pantheon of quarterbacks. But Giants fans, he had the two rings. But I've always said that I thought he had just two great postseason runs. But other than that, his career has been, you know, there's been holes in his career.
I mean, it is pretty bad there, Bone. It's pretty bad. But I think he'll beat the Falcons, though. Their defense is pretty poor. I think, Bone, you and I can go out there and beat the Falcons D right now.
Yeah, it's a shame. It's amazing. The injuries, I think, injuries are taking a toll on Atlanta's defense, I think. I think it's probably the biggest thing. And you see the NFL, I say most teams don't have depth because of just salary cap situations and just because it's just a violent, brutal sport. But it's hard to get to gather depth. And you see teams that are having some problems with depth. You see even the Rams are starting to thin out a little bit. Even though they're undefeated, you see a team like the Rams that have injury problems as well. So I think no team is impervious from injury problems, and you're seeing what they were with the Falcons. That being said, I'm sorry, they're beating the Giants when they play.
You got that right, man. Oh, man. Now, Bone, what about the New York Knicks getting close to opening night? Joakim Noah is still there. He's not been waived yet. I'm still hearing that Courtney Lee's on the block, even though they denied it publicly. But he's on the block still. I have good sourcing on that. What's your feelings on the Knicks, man? And I'm hearing Durant has eyes for the Garden. Not buying it because the Knicks gonna be in the tank this year. No Kristaps Porzingis. They're gonna probably hold him out the whole year. So, what is the buzz around the Garden so far? What you're hearing around there that they let out of the bin? You know, the Garden is so secretive over there.
Yeah, I mean, you're hearing what I hear. I still think that if any superstar joins Kristaps, it's going to be Kyrie first. I know the rumors and all the hope and dreams are about Kevin Durant coming. I'm still not sure if that happens. If anyone comes, like I said, it's going to be Kyrie. I think that's probably the worst kept secret in the NBA right now. Because of Kyrie's affinity towards New York. He's from the area, from Jersey. So I think if anyone comes, it's him. Durant comes, and that changes almost everything as far as shifting balance of power in the East. I mean, if then you find a way to add Durant and Kyrie to go along with a healthy Kristaps, then we got something. But for now, I say pump your brakes, Knicks fans. I don't see that happening. I don't see that big three forming just yet. As far as Joakim, I think he eventually will be bought out or stretched. I still think Courtney still gets moved. If the Knicks are smart enough and they come off that ridiculous price they had last year of a one, they wanted a one for him and Kylo Quinn. If they come off that ridiculous price tag, then you'll see also Lee moved as well.
Yeah, I think my man Courtney Lee will look good in a Hawks jersey for a second round pick. Just saying. Just need some people I know I can talk to on the planes, you know.
Yeah, at least a Courtney there. At least you have a friend in the locker room that won't get shunned or muzzled by certain guys.
Or NVC's my friend too, so I got VC for sure. You know.
Yes.
You know, at least Courtney Lee won't tap dance like others on the Hawks team, who I won't name. Tap dancing for the man. I think we all send guy to that house in D.C. to meet with that idiot rapper from Chicago, that orange Cheeto. I'm just saying.
I can imagine once the season starts, other than VC, who's really going to open up to you? I mean, I know it's a new regime down there, so things might be a little more lax. Hopefully you'll have, you know, a better access, you know, the upcoming season.
Well, you know, I think it's already thawing out because I'm already proving that I'm more like them than somebody else. Because there is a certain tap dancer who starts, who has said don't talk to him because he is loyal to somebody in another state. Yeah. So I'm fighting a battle bone between, hey, don't trust him, he's a mole, and he's loyal to somebody else, and hey, he's...
Yeah.
So, yeah, we have that. But it's each day go by, we thaw out the ice, we realize, damn, he's like us.
Yes. I think players see that. I think players are very perceptive, and they know who's real, who's not real. So, eventually, I think the ice will thaw for you, definitely.
Yes, indeed. Well, folks, Boston Bones, 71, coming next after the break. It's the Boss Report. Bones, we laughing at all these Florida hurricane wire stories we have because they are coming fast and furious, folks, off the wire. So, folks, you can stay with us, Boss and Bone, here on the Boss Man Show.
Tell me what you gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Man Show, Boss and Bone, time for your Boss Report featuring a lot of Florida hurricane stories. Bone, are you ready for this week's report, Bone, knowing that Florida had a big storm, but all the madness happening after the hurricane with the Florida residents going crazy down there?
Yeah, good to hear what's going on. As far as people getting dismembered, people having their junk bit off, or guys like Derek Lewis, and that excuse. I'm sure there's some of those in there as well.
You get there right. So, folks, you've been waiting on it. It's time for it. It's here. It's Boss Report. First story bone is this. Florida man arrested after getting tased after recklessly driving a stolen tractor trailer in the middle of a driving hurricane, Category 4 hurricane rainstorm near Panama City, Florida.
Huh. He drove into all the rain and the winds and stuff.
Just still a trying trailer. He said he wanted to collect some chickens and buy some milk.
All right. So he had a game plan. I mean, at least you'd think that he had some kind of game plan working in his own mind, as warped as it sounded. The fact that he got tased, I mean, the game plan went awry, but at least I get credit for having a game plan for once. Because how many fools only had game plans?
He got tased in the middle of a hurricane.
That was very shocking.
Think about how bad it is. This man was tased. I'm surprised he's living. Isn't that like electricity when you get tased? Electricity, water don't mix. Probably he wasn't electrocuted to death.
Yeah, like I said, the game plan, it wasn't fully thought out. He had a plan, he stuck to it. But the fact that you're getting tased in the rain, that doesn't sound like a great ending to your night.
Naked Florida man gets blown on the top of a roof while shooting a Facebook Live video from inside the eye of the hurricane.
So he won that real inside access. He got it. He got the full inside access. So I give him credit. He's probably a budding journalist. I think doing the Florida way.
Exactly. He got blown on top of a roof. That's even better. Like, it's like, here you go, loser. Roof. Florida couple arrested after being caught having sex in the middle of some rising flood water.
Well, I guess they weren't near a beach, so there's no sex on the beach. So that was probably the next best option, was to do it in a hurricane.
Yeah, like, I'm going to try to get for cover. I'm not going out to get my freak on in rising flood hurricane water, bone.
Well, I mean, I think it's better to do that than with alligators. So, as you heard previous stories. So, I mean, but that at the end of the day is just stupid.
Exactly. We got this. Florida man arrested, telling police that the drugs plenty in his house during the storm. Planted there because, quote, his balls was hot.
Ha! Derek Lewis, is that you?
Exactly! So, you try to tell me the ghost put drugs in your house because, quote, your balls was hot?
I'll tell you what, he might have fought that game plan, Derek Lewis, because, hey, Derek's getting paid because he's fighting Dan Cormier next. So, that's a step up. So, maybe this guy in Florida on the game plan, you know, and try to copy it.
Exactly. Get this. Florida woman arrested after trying to bite off boyfriend's Johnson with her pet squirrel because he wouldn't take her down to the beach to enjoy the storm.
Come again now. See, the bite of the junk, I mean, it's terrible, and it's kind of shocking. But did you say a pet squirrel?
Yes, her pet squirrel had to bite his junk off, too.
All right, so the fact that she had a pet squirrel, I think, supersedes the fact about any junk biting. Junk biting is horrible. I don't say at any man. But the fact that she had a pet squirrel, to me, is utterly fascinating.
Exactly. Terrible. This is crazy. We had this Florida man arrested for going to the hurricane shelter and offering people bottles of his warm urine as liquid to drink.
Oh, what? He does a refreshing idea. Was he on meth?
I don't know, but he had to be on something to actually bottle up his warm urine to give people for liquid to drink.
Did anyone accept his offer?
Yes, some did, unfortunately.
Oh, my goodness. Did they think it was lemonade or apple juice?
They say it was very, quote, tangy and warm.
Tangy. Tangy. Oh, my God. People are a mess. And what's going on with your state? They're now taking warm, tangy tea. And knowing that it's tea, I mean, I can say a dude trick and say, hey, here's a warm apple juice, and sip into it. Okay, I get that. That's wrong. Snacking is wrong, but I get that. But to knowingly know that it's someone else's urine you're drinking, that's a nasty.
Exactly. Florida woman arrested after hurricane relief shelter after taking a boyfriend with a plastic knife because he wouldn't have sex with her on the rented cot for the night.
So she threatened him? She threatened him
with a plastic knife.
A plastic knife. Now, if she cut off any junkies there with a plastic knife, that is probably the worst possible scenario. Plastic knife don't have any kind of edge to it.
Exactly. And this is even crazy, bro. Florida man arrested after making counterfeit money at the public library and handing out to hurricane relief victims at the shelter.
But he's trying to do good. He's trying to be like Robin Hood, I guess, in a way. But he went out the wrong way.
Exactly. He got there right. And we got Florida men arrested after putting a fellow evacuee in the walls of Jericho, looking at his girlfriend a little bit too much.
I'm disappointed that Stone Cold Thunder. But the wall of Jericho is pretty hard to pull off on a grown man, because you have to get them on their back first and get the legs up in the air and turn them over. Now, what guy is going to allow that to happen without a fight back? But I'm still disappointed that it wasn't a Stone Cold Thunder involved.
Well, he hit him with a chair.
Oh, chair shots good. Chair shots are always like a good plan B. But I've seen some deadly chair shots in my lifetime as an old fan of wrestling. So a chair shot is pretty cool.
Yes, indeed. Florida man arrested after taking girlfriend out to dinner on a boat in the middle of the hurricane that isn't his. I thought I was going to damage to the boat when the storm blows the boat into the port and destroys the front of it.
But he took a boat out in the middle of the eye of the storm?
Yes, like a fool.
Did he not watch Perfect Storm? Did he not watch how these boats get tossed around as if they're toys?
I guess he missed that memo.
I mean, there's dumb, and then there's Florida type dumb, and that's the kick. Because if you're a true Florian, you know about storms and how awful they are, how powerful they are. So to take a boat, even if it's not yours, take a boat and put it in the eye of the storm. That's ridiculous.
Exactly. Florida men arrested to bring an alligator to the rescue shelter to eat a neighbor's dog who would not give him any charcoal for a barbecue last week.
So what did Jay-Z say? So like if you shoot my dog, I kill your cat. So this guy tried to go a step further and just try to have this dude's dog, his pet dog eaten. I mean,
at the shelter.
At the shelter, no less. Yeah, that is something else, man.
We got this. Struggling Florida man arrested after pulling out his junk in the dumpster by the rescue shelter to scare patrons.
To scare patrons? I mean, was it because it's like on a monster dog? Or how was trying to scare patrons?
Well, he wanted them to be scared that he might stick his junk in them, but he's got arrested for it instead.
Well, but he thought that was a good idea too, huh?
He did.
To scare patrons. What is wrong with your state?
Man, this is bad. This all happened during the day of the hurricane. This is even worse. You know what I'm saying? This all happened the same day of the hurricane. That's what's so bad about it.
That's what I'm saying, because we gotta wonder, like, don't they have the priorities mixed up? The storm means you should be trying to get the hell out of wherever you are or hunker down, not taking a dunk out, not trying to feed a pet dog alligators, not taking your boat out in the eye of the storm. What is wrong with your state?
I have no idea. Get this. We got 7 Florida men arrested after looting the Foot Locker, the Sears, the Dress Barn, the Dick's Sporting Goods, and the Best Buy after it was closed due to flooding.
So first of all, like I said, they should already been hunkering down and not worrying about buying some J's. I mean, stealing some J's. Because obviously, at the store itself, and we know how much America loves commerce and loves capitalism. So if major stores are closing and willing to bypass sales, you know that storm is serious coming.
Exactly. These guys out here looting, they had a boat too to loot with.
They had a boat. I wish Gary got them.
You're right. You should have got these idiots as well. And Florida man arrested trying to crash and stole a Lambo into a truck, fleeing a stolen Mercedes, trying to evade the flood.
And what do you feel now? What do you feel?
He stole a Lambo, crashed into a truck, then he's fleeing the Mercedes. He crashed into a tree. Then he is still in the Kia to flee the whole tire flood.
So this dude is just going backwards. So, like, hit the Lambo to the Mercedes to the Kia.
Terrible, ain't it?
I tell you, you guys on the country, y'all always clown on Jersey. But we don't ever do that kind of stuff down here, up here in Jersey. Man. I'm telling you right now, we don't do that kind of stuff.
Exactly. And finally, Bones, a bad story we don't like, but here we go. Florida woman arrested after biting off boyfriend's junk and he ate the last sandwich at the shelter.
It depends on what kind of sandwich it is, because some sandwiches, I know up here in Jersey, we have some banging sandwich boxes.
It was a club sandwich with turkey, roast beef, and ham.
All right. That's
Swiss cheese. And she bit him off the last one.
I probably be salty too. Now I wouldn't go fight anyone's junk off, but I think I'd be also salty.
Now, Bone, before we close up today's Boss Report, why could these people not bite off junk in the middle of a hurricane? Like, why? At least it's a hurricane. We have to keep saying junk. We can't get to the hospital to get junk reattached if we bite it off.
I never understood the biting of a junk. Maybe cut it off, which sounds horrible. Maybe cut it with biting. I mean, I don't get how they go out punching out in Florida.
Exactly. But, folks, please, Boss Report, all Florida hurricane stories, all Jupiter, Florida is off the chain as usual. This week we'll go national next week a little bit, but I had to share with you this week's hurricane stories from Florida because they're one of a kind. Boom. Great job as always, my good brother. We'll talk to you next week, my man.
Yes, sir. Can't wait.
No doubt, folks. It's Boss and Bone on the Boss Man Show. We are out. And if you don't know, now you know.